NFL has us on the west coast of the Sunshine State. Downtown Tampa's the spot, Raymond James Stadium. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. With fall around the corner, football is back, America, and we're underway on EA Sports. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And no run back on this one, so the new season will begin at the 25-yard line. Much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and nine, Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans.
Defensively here, Charles, I'd have to imagine coming up with a game plan to stop Tom Brady. Many have tried, few have succeeded. But what do you see as their best course of action?
Well, besides stating the obvious, which is having great guys who can cover, and we know how difficult that is in the NFL, I say it's inside pressure. The guy's up the middle in his face because he's not the type of athlete who can get out to the perimeter and hurt you. He likes to step up in the pocket and throw downfield. If you have a couple of good pass rushers right in his face, right in his grill, that's your best chance to slow him down.
Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of two. Jones. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
3 yards remain for second down. On play action, it's Brady. This is caught by Evans. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 34-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 34. Hey, watch the slant. Shotgun now for Brady. And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Been a nice start there to the aerial attack to pick up the first.
And I think preseason is officially over now. Getting into the groove of the regular season, that's a great way to get started. First drive of the season, what a nice completion.
They'll run on first down. Bernard, absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Here's Brady to throw. Touchdown! Antonio Brown from 19 yards away. And the Buccaneers are on the board here first in the season opener. Excellent start there. First drive of the season. Big time success putting it in the end zone.
And remember, that was done without any real map of how to do it. In other words, the deeper you get into the season, you get game film to work off of, tendencies to work off of. The first drive of the season, things can be entirely different than what you've seen in the past. It's a really good job of execution by them.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And he rifles one incomplete. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Give him 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. Throwing, Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. Touchdown, Cowboys! And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Dak Prescott, probably not the first name you think of in terms of strongest arms in the NFL, but he showed it off there. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. We'll see a return here from the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another shot here with a first and 10. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Handoff. Now Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
So a 5-yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to 2nd and 15. Here's Brady. Right side, that's complete to Gronkowski.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Now Brady. This one complete to Giovanni Bernard. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down. They needed 5 there on third down. He winds up getting 7. Move the chains. A gain of 7 on third down. First and 10, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. But it'll be 2nd down.
He's got 1 touchdown pass already in this quarter. Obviously looking for number 2, and definitely not playing the check down game.
2nd and 10. Now Bernard. And not much running room. Down to the 32. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Throwing is Brady on 3rd down.
He's going to drop this one down to Bernard.
And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And Succop will put this one right through. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defense is awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the throw.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
CeeDee Lamb is intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Now Prescott. Swinging this out for Pollard.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, short tackle.
On third down, it's Prescott. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The third down conversion successful. A gain of 11. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Again to Elliott. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. The give is to Elliott. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. The running game fully in sync, 1-11 on that play.
And sometimes it comes from the offensive coordinator, understanding what he thinks the defense is going to do and dialing up the perfect play. Sometimes the quarterback, though, can look at the defense, realize he needs to change it to a run, and that gets it done in a big way as well.
Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. They'll run with Elliott. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. That ball is caught. It's Gallup. Touchdown, Cowboys. Michael Gallup, 38 yards. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And the lead is now 14-10. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Evans has it left side. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. The Bucs on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 11. From the gun, it's Brady. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 43. Now a play fake, Brady. Eluding the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Now they'll toss to Jones running left. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
The Bucs on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third down and 12. Throwing now is Brady. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Check it, reload!
Brady gives this one off to Jones. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
On play action, now Brady. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
Ready?
A give to Jones. He gets it forward for four, maybe five, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back. Brady now to throw. On the screen, Bernard. Not much there, only a yard.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Behind the sticks here with a second and 15. A draw play, Bernard. It's a gain of four, but they're still looking up here at a tough third and 11.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
This offense, 2 for 2 on third downs on this drive. They're in for a tough test here, though, third and long. Now Brady. And this is caught by Evans. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in, and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort. But instead, he sets his guys up in excellent shape for a first and goal.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. Fournette. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
Jones, and he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones, fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Buccaneers have once again taken the lead. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. Oh, there's Gallup. Nice catch. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Give him 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Play fake. Here's Prescott. He's got his man. It's Gallup. That he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That's good for 28 yards. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 26-yard line. Elliott, toss right. He's able to get six, a nice pickup down to the 21.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
The last run got six, now second and four. Now Elliott. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down. Here's Prescott. But incomplete. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down. But the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
Yeah, things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. To throw on second and 10, Brady. And this is caught. It's Brown. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 33 yards that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. The give is to Jones. Jalen Smith, the NFC's leading tackler in 2020, there on the stop defensively.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And the last run got three. Now here's second and 7. To throw is Brady. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So a PI call going to cost him there defensively. What did you see?
Well, I think it's the right call, partner, because sometimes we'll see officials kind of let them play. But by the letter of the law, that's definitely a penalty.
Brady now on first down. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Micah Parsons brings him down, and that's a play he's going to remember. The first sack of his NFL career. We remind you that coming up at the half, we'll hand things off to Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have scores from earlier today, plus a look ahead as well, so you won't want to miss that. A lot going on here in week one. Brady's throw there complete.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Throwing on first down is Brady. Over the middle, he finds Godwin complete. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. An excellent pickup of 20 yards.
And Chris Godwin, one of those great unselfish players. Remember, he gave up his uniform number to Tom Brady when he got into town. He's kind of known as the 1B to Mike Evans' 1A. In this Tampa Bay pecking order among receivers, he makes a nice catch there.
They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones, already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Bucs are going to take the lead. Extra point put through by Sucker. And they will take a 7-point lead. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with 25 seconds to go, we'll see how they want to play this. Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. On second and inches, Prescott. Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Prescott now. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. And that's caught inside the 35. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
Well, he reminded us that he was a 1,000-yard receiver a year ago as he starts off week one picking up right where he left off. He told us at the end of the preseason he was primed for a big year. He just gave us excellent evidence of his belief. Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it, and this one winds up no good.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. 1 second, all that remains. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. First down and much more here for Jones. And he takes it across the 50 to the 46-yard line. So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Hello. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
A good pickup there, 26 yards. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school. Elliott going to get it again on second down. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Off the play fake, Prescott. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Schultz. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Prescott. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And the return will stop them well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. Fournette, first down, still going. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Leonard Fournette, which for a big back, he can cover a lot of ground, and he showed off the athleticism there as he broke off a big one.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates, they're looking at you. And let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to him. That's not how football works, but he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. To Fournette. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 92 yards rushing for him now here in week one. A very solid start to this new campaign. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And a short gain here, down to the 22. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Quick throw caught by Godwin. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. This is four and in, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty, but when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Succop's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. And right now, Charles, this is about building that lead little by little. And they're able to do just that.
And it gets them past the key number of 16, so this is now a three-score lead. Not time to exhale just yet, but that might prove to be an important 3 points before things are said and done.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again.
And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. Hey, you need a big play? Go to your big play guy.
Listen, that's football 101. When you have to have it, you expect that guy to step up. A lot of people call these receivers divas. Sometimes just leadership when they get in the huddle and say, get me the ball. I'm about to make a big play.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Tenth carry now for Elliott. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now Prescott. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Cooper. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down in a nice little game. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down. Again, it's Cooper as he makes the catch. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. A solid pickup of 5 and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. They'll throw again. Prescott.
They'll drop this underneath to Pollard.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Looking to throw, Prescott. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. And Dominican Sue with a sack. We've seen that a ton since he entered the league in 2010. Zerline's kick is up and through. And that will close the gap down to 14. So the response to that touchdown on the other side to begin the third quarter. Look, just 3 points, but still a response nonetheless.
You're exactly right about that, because I think you needed to answer back with something, even though it's not six. Just enough to send the message that says, hey, we're not going away.
Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best.
Put your foot on the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. And Brake, the tight end's got it. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up. To throw, it's Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Here's Bradley Pinion now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now, because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Throwing, Prescott. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for them. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Prescott. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their...
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Jalen Smith, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Another try after the first down sack. Brady goes right side, complete to Gronk. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Let's just make this one simple. Could he be any more open than he was on that play?
Yeah, they lost him going to the outside.
Hard to believe, because you go through your accounting on each and every defensive snap. Who's got who? What defense you're in? That was totally a blown coverage.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Getting it out wide here to Bernard. And he stopped up short of the first as they tackle him down at about the 36. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
I think that we all figured when he caught it that short of the marker that the defense almost relaxed and said, we've got this covered. And then all of a sudden, space to run after the catch. And now they're screaming, somebody get him down. Fortunately, they got to him and forced the fourth down.
This is taken at the 15. So just a 3-yard return following a punt of 45. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a 2-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 53 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
He'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. His throw incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
The Cowboys on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5. To throw is Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on 3rd down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way. Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
Now they go for it on 4th down, but that pass pass is knocked away and incomplete. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. They'll start out here with a jet sweep. Finding room to the 20 and down to the 16-yard line. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first.
I think the reason that this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
On second down, here's Fournette. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there, and on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. They slot Gronkowski outright. On second and goal. Brady, and he's got his man in stride, complete, and in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Chris Godwin from 3 yards out, and the Bucs are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point up and good by Succa, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, but it's going to be second down. It'll be a handoff to Pollard. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Let's face it, that's just a helpless feeling for a running back there. He's looking up to find a hole, and all he finds is a whole lot of ticked off linebacker.
On third down, it's Prescott. He'll fire this deep for Gallup, and Prescott, his third interception. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. That interception may be the exclamation mark on what really all around has been a good performance.
A fantastic performance. They will enjoy film session. Their grade should be very good on this one. I think the next time the offense gets the ball, I just think about running it and getting the clock done and getting the heck out of here.
And by the way, semantics here, but before the grammar police come after me, I think it's exclamation point, not mark, right?
You're asking me? Seriously?
Yeah, you're smarter than me. Everybody knows that.
Listen, I go with what you say, my man.
Jones with a carry on first down, but I don't think he even made it back to the line of scrimmage as the defense all over that one.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. The Bucs on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third down and 12. Brady now to throw. And he finds Howard complete. It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay.
The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
On first down, it's Jones. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
Trayvon Diggs getting the tackle.
Here's second and 10. On the draw, here's Bernard. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Open man has got it. It's complete.
And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A gain of 18 and a new set of downs.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
Fournette running out of the gun. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line.
106 yards on the ground for him now as he's gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
Good gain there on first down. It keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively.
And the Bucs are going to be set up with a first and goal as good running gets him down to about the 4-yard line.
That leads us to a first and goal. It's a pickup of 8. Fournette. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1.
But a spotlight hit him once already tonight as he got into the end zone. He was trying to make it a double spotlight, wasn't he?
But credit the defense, bottling him up, not letting him get in for the second score there. Second and goal from the 1. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Leonard Fournette, already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Buccaneers are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead.
Extra point put through by Suckup, and that'll increase their lead to 28.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try to put points on the board.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw to the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Carlton Davis picks it. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
People constantly make the joke about defensive backs being wide receivers that can't catch. But Carlton Davis puts a line to that theory. Snags that one. And he's not a guy who gets a lot of publicity. But a big part of the Bucs' run to the Super Bowl title last year. A former second-round pick out of Auburn in 2018. He led the Buccaneers with 4 interceptions.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. We're not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Jones. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. On the tackle, it's Randy Gregory. Defensively, they know the situation. They stacked the line. Heck, that was a goal line set right there.
And it's the right play for them, exactly what they have to do. They want to take away every gap, every crack, and make sure no one can get through it. But here's the deal, though. You've worked on offense all year long about these types of defensive fronts. If they can penetrate it at all, your runner has a chance to go a long way behind.
It could be a house call. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here.